Dear students, today I will discuss the introduction to the poem Ode to the West Wind. The poem Ode to the West Wind is one of Shelley's greatest achievements and has a deep human and political interest. His ambition to regenerate the society was not fulfilled. Actually, the ambition of Shelley to regenerate the society was not fulfilled. So he was very much disappointed. He was feeling very much despondent and restless. And this poem embodies his revolutionary and reformist zeal, his high idealism and invincible optimism despite the crushing circumstances of his life. He desires a social change and regeneration in the human and natural world, and the West Wind acts as a driving force, and it is a symbol of revolution. It acts as a destroyer as well as a preserver. The first three stanzas describe the effect of the wind, of the West Wind, on land, on earth, in the sky, and in the sea. In the last two stanzas of the poem, Shelley identifies himself with the West Wind, which makes ground for a new revolution. He hopes to bring about a new social order with the help of the West Wind. He appeals to the West Wind to lift him as a wave, as a leaf, so that he could feel the power of the West Wind. Just as the West Wind acts the deed of changing, he just wants to change the society, the world, with the help of West Wind. He asks the wind to take his thoughts and spread them all over the world to wake up the youth with his ideas. Shelley always wanted to change the society with the help of his writing. He wanted that the youth should come ahead so that there should be a new generation with new thoughts and new ideas. So these are the views which are shared in this poem.